Alright then, boy! I am Lodemcum Innit, and today I'm going to be playing through Constructor. This is a game I remember from my childhood. Very complicated, very tricky game. I had it on PlayStation, I didn't have it on PC. But without further ado, I will show you the intro and crack on. Come on, intro. There you have it. I always remember thinking, even as a child, that's an absolutely horrific way to die, drowning in concrete while this sadist watches you die. What a psychopath. But anyway, on with the bloody game. Yes, I'm going to be playing through... I'm not going to be playing with a computer on this level. I might do a playthrough later with the computer. It becomes a bit too complicated just for... I haven't played this game in ages, so I want to ease my way back in, basically. I'm going to be doing the Egomania objective, which is basically to build every single house in the game, including the special commissions. So it may take me a little bit of time, but it should be maybe 3 or 4 episodes, I reckon. I'm going to be the yellow people because I fancy it. And I'm just going to play through the first map, which is Greenfields, on easy as well. Yep, so here you go, basically. And this is your little map, your overview. You're a constructor, you're basically a construction team. You're supposed to build a massive oligopoly, can take over the world, and etc, etc. Here's your overview map, and you start with the first little plot of land, and the first job is not to go onto there, basically. Your first job is to build the wood yard. This is your basic construction material. Boom, get the workmen in. This is to call your work teams in, this little button. You get 4 types of construction material: wood, concrete, brick, and steel. Have I called both teams in? Yes, I have. And a work team's made up of 1 foreman and 3 workers. Or you can add more workers as well if you feel like it. Improve the efficiency. Congratulations! You've finished your first new wood yard. To restock it, move work team into the building. Yes, I'll do that now quickly. This is your basic button. So call work team in. Manual repair of house. I want to do that right now, just to build up some wood. Your wood is up here, and you want to, these are your repairmen. Basically, you want to turn on auto repair, and they'll go around and repair your buildings. This game has its a unique brand of humour to it. It's absolutely amazing. All unique voice acting, all unique idea. It's very, very complex as well, very in-depth. I mean, listen, this is great.
What do you want?
What do you want? And you can click on your foreman, your builders. They all have
what?
Unique animations and sounds. Well, oh, no, too loud. Foreman.
Who, what, eh?
It's brilliant. It's absolutely amazing. And then you can start building your houses, basically, as soon as you built your wood yard. Do I have enough room to build 2 houses back to back? I'm going to say I do. I want to build it out just a little bit like this. So you've got a tiny little garden. I'll explain why in a minute. All right, call in your work team. And I'll also build another one. Right, back to back. This is the second... Ooh, don't have a spare work team available. Yeah, so now I've built the wood yard, you get your first 3 basic properties. Log cabin, wooden lodge, stow-to hut. Well done! Your first home has been completed and it's ready to be rented out for the first time. Building a variety of types of houses will expand your choice in the future. Yeah, so it kind of walks you through it, basically. You can only put level 1 tenants in these. I'll show you that in just a second. And... I'll get some tenants in. Get them building this first of all. And I'll move in. Now, basically, your tenants are for two things, well, at this stage anyway, for money or for reproduction. And since I am right next to the HQ, I want this to be for reproduction. These are the slobs, basically. They are your best for reproducing. And level one tenants can reproduce workers, which you can convert at your HQ, which I'll show you in a minute as well. It's brilliant. Look, you've got music for here. You've got music here in the background, and you've also got music when you move in your tenants. This is like their basic music when they're kind of like unhappy, but not really unhappy to be complaining yet. And if they improve in happiness, it will change to a different tune. Okay. While I'm at it, I'll build. I won't build that one yet, actually. I have. All four of these people will be for creating tenants and for workers. Create the babies. I've already got a complaint, and that will be because I have a wood factory in the works. Basically, people complain a lot in this game, as you'll find out. DJ, how can you expect me to put up with that infernal noise coming from your factory? You have 80 days to solve this problem. Yours sincerely, Rodney Cleaver, lovely name. And it's the same again. Yeah, it's basically because I have a factory going on over here. Dwight Haggis, nice name. Fail and you get 30 black marks. If you get too many black marks, the council will come and shut you down. This one is an easy problem to get rid of. Just get this guy over here and
Righto.
send his work team out of the woodyard. Quite simple. All right, so they're creating workers. They're creating workers. These guys can be for tenants. Create a couple more. You can create level one tenants. These guys can create some level two tenants. So yeah, here you go. You've got the breakdown. I've got two workers in the HQ. You need these guys to convert them into like repairmen, foremen, tenants, and create tenants back into workmen. So in the HQ, I've got. This is really important. You need to keep an eye on this because if you run out of tenants, then you haven't got anywhere to put them, and your houses will go derelict and explode-o. So I've got one level one in production at the moment and one in the HQ. So I can put one more in this house over here. Boom. Okay, now I want you to create. I want builders out of you as well. Gonna need them all. Okay, so at this level, you've got your fences here. You're gonna need to put a little fence around here. Level one tenants really don't give a shit about what fence they have, to be honest. So just build them the cheapest one. 300, yeah. The hedge is the cheapest one you can get. And before these guys start complaining, actually, I'm a bit tight of cash at the moment. I'm not going to do that just yet. What I am going to do is I'm going to do up. When I start to run out of, I need to do up the rooms, basically. These rooms do different things. And the bedroom creates fast reproduction. So who's creating my level one tenants? Is it you? It is. Right. Call in the work gang. Pay for the building to be upgraded. They come in four grades, standard, grade 2, grade 3, and grade 4, and each time it will increase the amount they reproduce. So loads of babies. And you can check what each thing does. Upgrading the bathroom will prevent leaks, less likely to make the building require less repairs, cheaper in the long run. Saves you having to repair it. I think this makes them less aware of what's going on around them. Yep, you can get away with having more like fires going on and explosions and stuff, and this just increases their lifespan, which is quite handy if you've got tenants that die quickly. So yeah, they should have the top grade now, which they'll be producing lots of people in there for me. And now what I'm going to do is buy up another plot of land, and this will be for money, basically. So now I'll build one of these lodges. Have a tiny garden for these guys, just so you can get a couple of trees in. They will complain later, generally, if they don't have any trees and stuff. These guys, I'm not going to change their fences until they complain. You can remain slobby, you slobs. Now I need to move this guy over here.
Hello.
All right. Nice little scouse repairman. Right, I've got one in HQ, one in production. I've got three loads of builders. That's good. Due to the high quality of your shacks, oh, thanks for calling my house shacks there. The Council Surveyor is going to let you build some proper houses after you've built the cement yard. Yeah, that's what I want. That's what I want to hear, mate. I want to get in the old cement yard. Right, and for rent, these guys are much better. They've got much more money and reproduction is a bit lower. So you can compare them here. These are the Greasers. Basically, Elvis impersonator. Ah, here's the secondary music you can hear now. When they're happy, they're like, woohoo, party on down. Whereas when they're a bit miffed, it'll sound like this. But they're only 0%. They're in the middle. You don't have to pay me rent. You're creating babies. Who cares? You should be happy. Right, now I want to build. Let's see, as you build up, you can start to build bigger structures here. Like cement yard, which I want to get building. But I also want to build in a few more houses and build up my rent as well. So let's get some cheap-ass houses. Cheap, nasty ones. I kind of... It's not the right shape. You know what? That's fine. I think I can get a... tree in there. They shouldn't complain. Yep, the cement yard has been finished and now up and running. You can start some real buildings. I need to call in the team over to here. And I need to create a few tenants. Oh, I've got enough. That's okay. Now the cement yard's built. I'll come back in here. Basically, you want to do it by blocks. I generally do because it makes life easier. So here will be a reproduction block. They'll reproduce tenants for you and workers. Here will be a money block where they'll pay for things. So that's your basic way of getting money is rent. So get these greasers in here as well. They can pay me rent. On one playthrough, I think I did all their living rooms up as well, so they wouldn't keep complaining about having to pay rent. But it's not necessary, you don't have to. How are we doing? One in HQ, one in production, so I can build another one. Oh my god, everyone's complaining. It's going to be about the factory, I guarantee it. Yep, it's the factory again. Doesn't matter, you can give them all double glazing so they won't complain about this as well later in life. But since you're only in here for a little while, you can just take them out before they all complain. Usually slobs aren't too bothered about work and stuff going on, but these guys obviously are. So here's your little meter telling you how many complaints you have as well. I haven't got any level 2 tenants yet. I don't need to. Now I've got the steel yard, I can start building other factories and stuff as well. Gadget shop is a must if you want to start getting tenants, level 2 tenants. You have to build this. This is where you get computers and stuff to train them up. So I want to have one of these people doing for level 2. Two workers and one for level 1, one for level 2. And now I've got enough wood. I'm going to move you over here.
Righto.
It's just on point. The voice animation's completely on point. Brilliant. Yeah, 1997. I don't know if I've mentioned it. They're doing an HD remake as well. I probably have said that already. Going senile all the time. Whatever. As you can see, construction has stopped here because I've run out of concrete. So once these guys get ramming up there, these guys will stop complaining. These guys will probably start complaining. And everything will be as it should. Right. These are your second level tenants' buildings. These are your concrete buildings, bungalow, Northern Mews and Council House. You'll get a different set of tenants for that. But I need to get some first. I need to start researching them. There we go. Gadget factory. Your gadget factory will be completed, allowing houses and gardens to start being improved. Gadgets from houses such as computers to build next level tenants can be manufactured. Thank you. Yeah, so you want to get some computers on the go. Once I get the brick factory, I can build a school, which means houses will be, you'll be able to upgrade to research the next level of tenant without having to build computers in your homes. But that won't be for a while. So you are doing builders. You are doing level ones. Yeah, I could do with bringing a team in over here. Upgrade your bedroom. You can start researching level 2 tenants for me. Also could do with some subways in here. When you're ready, I'll call a guy back here. I'll build a couple more of them, actually. Subways are really useful. They build you, get your teams from A to B really fast. They'll just go down there and then they'll pop up in a different corner or something. Okay, so keep doing the bedroom up. It will increase their happiness as well. If you do the rooms up, they'll be a lot happier and complain less. Thank you. Oh yeah, I'll show the animations as well. Get the top right hand corner, you get to spin around and have a look at these all. Come on, hurry up, boys. There we go. And you can have a little look around. I'll show the other ones in more detail later. It's great. Even the guy who does like the bedrooms has an animation. It's great. Okay, what have I got in here? I've got 8 workers. I can create another team in a minute. And I'll create another work gang. So you guys, you should go and get a home computer. Meanwhile, let's get another house on the go. I'll build one more renter accommodation. Actually, the last one I'll build will be that. Build another really small, cheap one. Let's build it over here. Change the foundation round. I'm in a bit of a bummer there. That will have to be... I should have extended that to there. The council will really get in your case for leaving blank spaces everywhere. Can I get 2 in there? No, you can't because they've got to be attached to the path. Okay, I could do that and then get 2 level 2s, couldn't I? Okay. Yeah, go on. Let's have another one of them. And then I could be able to build 2 of these in this gap here, hopefully. Okay, you should be done in here. They've got the computer and they can now start researching level 2 tenants. Grand. Meanwhile, I will build... get another workman. Handyman. And I will also have a foreman.
Who are I?
And I will create a new work gang once I've got 3 workers. Could do with a bit more wood. Right, 1 more greaser. Oh yeah, you get an animation for when they're complaining as well, which I'll show later. You guys just continue to pay rent. And as soon as I have a level 2 tenant, I will build. How close are you? Not very. You've got the master bedroom. Come on, get in there. Get making use of it. You see, every time they have a child, it takes a bit longer for them to reproduce another one. I could do with some more level 2 tenants being produced, but I will get my level 2 tenants to produce some more of themselves. Generally, you want to have about 2 on the go of everything. So 2 level 2 tenants being produced, 2 level 1 tenants being produced, depending on how many houses you've got. Here I've got a lot, so I could always just switch these guys over to create a few more when these guys die. They've got a certain span of life left here, you see. And if I didn't have these guys running around repairing my houses, they would all fall into disrepair and set on fire and go kaboom. How far off am I, actually?
What?
Fair way. I don't want to build them and just leave them sitting there doing nothing. This will be a rent block, basically. Everyone here will pay me rent. And then I'll get some of these guys to produce some more level 2s. So, how are we doing for builders? Probably got enough now. Definitely got enough builders. So, what I want to do is swap you guys. Change you to level 2. So, the micromanaging is beginning to start already. You've got to keep swapping things up to see for what to change up for what you need. Like, now I need more level 2 tenants. So... here's the level 2 bedroom. Lovely little 90s lava lamp there. Art Deco-esque, isn't it? Yep, there is your level 3. I was actually a painting of Vincent van Gogh on the wall in the second level. I was racking my brain trying to remember though. What it was called, it's a portrait of Vincent van Gogh on the wall. If anyone saw that, well done. And there you have it. Top level, top whack. Where's your computer? Why haven't you got it yet? Slops and lazy. Here we go, coming back with it right now. You can even click on them and you've got a little animation for them as well. Della Haggis. Not bad. And you get to work on getting me some level 2s. Come on, what's going on, boys? We need to start, crack on, start building. Yeah, like I say, this on this level, all you've got to do is build every type of house. And you'll get level 5 tenants later on in the game, and they will produce for you special... I can't remember what they're called. Special plans. Call them special plans. Special commissions. There you go. That's what they are. Since I can't get the small one in here as well, I'll just have to build. I don't think I can get 2 small houses in here. Yeah, I think it's... I don't know. See, if you place it, then you've got to destroy the plot if it doesn't fit. So I don't want to risk it. I'm not going to risk it because it's wasted money if you do. Almost got a level 2 tent now, so let's build the largest one. Take up the space. Oh, I don't have enough wood. Call them in. Call in the boys. So yeah, you're constantly managing everything, all your resources, all your tenants. It gets a lot more complicated later in the game, believe me. Okay. Let's call in another work game. Oh yeah, I haven't created this work game. I've created this guy. I haven't created his work game. So here are the guys in the HQ. 1, 2, 3. I'll have a 3-man work team. They've all got little different skills here, but it doesn't matter how you organize them. They all make the same thing. And then select group together. But one thing that is worth noting. Oh, show you in a second. Congratulations, you've created sufficient resources that you're now able to upgrade them. Yeah, you can upgrade your... oh my god, that's noisy. Upgrade your resource, which will produce better things at your gadget house. And it will also create different fences and etc. And you can also store 50 rather than 25. Yeah, where's the window where I can actually look at this guy again? Yeah, building the workforce. This is their health bar and this is their experience bar. I've never noticed this making too much difference. When it reaches max, they like kind of gain a level, I guess, and become a bit more a bit better at their job. Right, yeah, everyone's complaining again because of this. Don't care. I still haven't got any level 2 tents. Very close to, though. And these guys are... You get the nerds... No, the hippies and the punks. And in here, I'm going to want to put the hippies because this is a rent block. I've got another workforce. I've got plenty of resources. Since this is going to be hippies, they don't want anything other than hedgerow. So let's get that on the go right now. Yeah, I've got all of that resource, right, so bring them out. Take them away. You can increase or decrease people's rents on here as well, but generally they just get really pissed off. So I just tend not to.
Okay.
That house is... Slobs will wreck a house as well. We've got a level 2 tenant though. They've just finished producing one. And now we can get in these guys. Yeah, see, the rent's a lot higher with them than the punks. The punks are your reproducers for level 2. Boom, get in there. You should be quite happy. They often complain about paying rent. They're like, well, I don't want to have to pay rent. Why can't you just not pay rent? Like, no, this is the modern world. Pay me. What's going on? Who's complaining? Slobs. No, greasers. Here you go. First person to complain about having a garden and nothing in it.
You would have thought that with a house my size, I would have had some trees and shade and give me some hair.
Basically, they just want trees. And I don't have any yet. 1, 2, 2, 2, 2. Call someone in. Yeah, this is why you want a little patch of garden so you can put trees in it, because everyone complains about not having things in the garden. That's why I don't give you big gardens, because you just complain. See, slobs are happy. They don't want trees. Just perfectly happy. Screwing. Okay. I kind of a bit desperate for level 2 tenants now, because these are taking forever. So the next one I get, well, this will be a reproduction block. Oh, I bet everyone's going to start complaining about not having trees now. Just one, two. What was that? What was there? I mean, a cuckoo noise. Anyway, if you want to place them, I usually place them really close to the door so you can get these things done quickly. One doesn't satisfy them. They need to have two. Oh, yeah, here we go. First person complaining about rent.
I don't believe it. I've been quite happy living here for the past couple of years and causing no problems. At least you could do it with just my rent.
And here you get the... See, Elvis incarnate with his lovely pink Elvis suit. What you do to combat this problem, just swap them over to creating babies. And then swap them back, and you fooled the tenant into thinking they haven't paid any rent. I bet you're going to be complaining about the same thing, so I'm going to pre-guess, which I've done correctly. You go back to pay me rent. What are you guys complaining about now?
I've been living there for ages, I've still got the grotty French or builders left behind.
Okay, fair point. You certainly do. Oh, yeah, this, listen to the slobs animation. This is really irritating. Babies and beer. Thank you. Okay, just you can have the cheapest fence going. Now I've got three work gangs, we can speed things up a bit. Yeah, shut up, shut up. God, I wouldn't want to live in that house. And I built it myself. Okay, what's going on? Right, you're happy, trees, you're happy. You're happy. Now we need to start tomb production. Two there. Oh, I can't build any yet, can I? I need you guys to get a move on. Two.
All right, calm down.
You've almost completed it. Okay. Level one. I've probably got enough of them now. I'll tell you what. Let's get you to get a computer. You can create some level 2 tenants for me as well. You just need to chop and change all the time, basically. So yeah, you can see in HQ I've got 3 level 1s. You want these for when they die. Here I've got none in there, but I've got a couple in production. All is well. Okay. When you've got the computer... I don't want to do it yet. If I build this room, then this will go right down. They'll produce another one of these builders, and it will take longer for them to reproduce level 2 tents. This, right, I need a subway as well for people collecting things, because they're taking way too long. There, right next to there. Then you have no excuse. Okay, level 2. Call you guys in. Call in change rooms, team. Oh dear. As a result of the last inspection by council, they decided your estates are too desolate and haphazard. You must improve the land uses by greater than 90% in the last 2 years. Failure to do this and result in being sacked. Yeah, this is the council. Because I've built a new estate and I haven't bought a new estate and I haven't built anything on it, they're pissed off. And here is the Van Gogh in the corner for anyone who spotted it the first time. Yeah, you get a move on. Running out of time and patience. I need some more computers. Oh, I've already got a team in there. Nice. Okay. And... yeah, how much money do I have? Not too much. I should just get away with building some of the smaller ones, I think. Can I build them back to back? No, there's not enough room. What about... a more square building, 3x3. No, they're going to have to be stretched. I don't want to build the expensive ones, just want to build the small ones. Yeah, I should have a level 2 tenant by now. These guys will be the punks. You guys haven't complained yet. It isn't until you get up to the higher levels that you get more rent from other people, like the yuppies and the nerds, but they create more problems as you go further up. So I'll build 2 of those if I can. How many do I have? Go back to HQ. None. Brilliant. Halfway there. You should have just produced one, which you have. Oh, you can click on them as well. Oh, too slow. And you are reported away there, so I can get one of these guys. How long have I got on my council mission before they get really pissed off? Okay. Not all that long. Who's complaining? Grotty Fence again. Greases. Yeah. Don't care. I can't build another one of them. I could just get some more slobs in there, but I'm not gonna. Yeah, police station, you don't need that when you haven't got any of the other enemy players, because you won't have any unsavory characters wandering around trying to cause you damage. And these are your like houses of ill repute, basically. You can build different things. They're not all sex shops. There is one, I think. One, maybe there isn't. I don't think there is. That's constructed too. They're for attacking the other player, which I don't have, so I'm not going to do. Yep, let's get these guys in. They're for reproduction. Yeah, I need a couple. I can't really... Hang on a minute. I can't have this as a whole reproduction area, because I kind of need some more rent. At the moment, I'm only getting a couple off these guys. This will be a mixed one. Right, let's get these guys in here anyway, quick. Get you to pay me rent for the time being, till I can build up a bit of cash. You'll be hearing that noise a lot. Grotty Fence. And another Grotty Fence, more than likely. Oh, it's these guys.
You would have thought it with a garden my size, you could put some trees in, man.
Here we go. Yeah, a bit like Neil had the young ones. Trees. Always with the trees. I mean, what land are these guys living in? Usually, if you buy a house or you're renting, it's your own duty to do up your garden, for God's sake. The punks, all they usually like to do is they're like, oh, turn on your factories, bleh, kick up a stink, annoy the neighbours. They love all that. Oh, what am I doing? I don't think so, mate. I need to get a crack in, really. Let's just build up one more bungalow. Actually, let's not. Let's finish off the set. Because now I can build a brickyard after this, which I need. And then I need to start getting level 3 tenants. Okay, you will get the trees. You'll be fine. Rent's going good. What about level 2 tenants? Got 3 in production. None actually available. But not to worry. These guys will produce level 2 tenants. And one of these guys should be fairly close. Yeah, it's them. Harvey Shrimp, Elvis Bacon, Daniel Dent, Elman Kettle. What lovely names. All common items. Yeah, keep them paying rent until they start to complain, which won't be long. I'll get these guys to pay some rent as well. Come on. Halfway through the council, they're going to get annoyed. You have done wonders of cement and wood, so the council have approved plans for your brickyard. Get building these brick houses. Indeed. I don't want fences. Move in the punks for reproduction. Keep them paying that. So yeah, now I'm going to need the brickyard. This thing is for building, obviously, brick houses. Build a brick house. Get them in there. And I want this to be filled with another set of level 2 tenants as well. Maybe one more level 1 as well, just for rent, because I've got a load of them. Yeah, so I have one more level 1. Cheapest chips. You can do rent. Your first brickyard has been completed and is ready for a work team. Why, thank you. Ah, good. You have successfully improved your land usage. Keep up the standard required. Or, to the land required, keep it up. Yeah. Tax bill. Okay. Tax bill now due. Yep. Basically, just you want to pay your tax as quick as possible, because otherwise you accumulate interest. And that is, I think it's this button. Pay outstanding tax, yeah. So yeah, at the moment, we are running a bit low on money. which is not good. I need to up the rent. Okay. I need to start getting some houses on the go, which I can start charging a lot more money for, which is your level 3s. Okay. Let's get some renters in here. And then I just want to build one more of those once I've got a level 2 tenant. You're halfway through. You're a quarter of the way through. What about you? You're basically done. Yeah, let's have one of these bad boys. Can't build any more of them. You get a certain amount per house you can build as well. Let's get that in. Let's get that on the go. Keep the rent coming in. And then I will start to upgrade these with computers. Actually, now I've built the brick. Now I've built the brick yard, sorry. I'll get different buildings in the utilities, which means I can get the school, which I want, because everyone doesn't need a computer. Then anyone can have children of any age, of any place. I only want a small plot, really. Where's the smallest I can get? It's 3.5, 3.5, 2. That's quite cheap. That's too much. Yeah, I'm going to want that in a second. Not just yet, though. Let's get everything in order first. Haven't got any of them. You can speed the game up, look, as well. Until I need it to stop again. You should have produced. Why have you not reproduced yet? Give me all your precious children so I can turn them into tenants. Go. Ah, oh, typical. Grotty fence. Yeah, as you can see, you've now got a brickyard. You can get the bricked hedge as well. And everything you upgrade goes up differently as well. I don't mind, you can have a different fence. Ah, oh, come on. I'm going to fire these tenants if they don't reproduce babies quicker. Where are they? Here we go. There we go. Snot-nosed kid. Gareth, was that Gareth Drainage? What a lovely name you have. Okay. Oh, I get bugger all rent out of them, really. I get more rent out of these guys than I do. I'm going to give one more hippie here. Just because I need to up the rent. These guys can produce 2 and 2. Ding, 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 ding. Even this music's amazing. It's like lounge music. I love it. Right, let's go. We better get a move on. Okay, I'll build the school and then I can get some of these people having children. Having important children. Okay, this can be reserved for brick houses now. I need to up the level of tenant. I can't build another one there. But I should be able to squeeze maybe 2 in there. Or another level 2. 4x4. Now I can have one of them and one more level 2 tenant, probably. Oh dear, I've run out of all the material I need. 1, 2, and 3. This is why you need 3 work teams, because... No? Why? What? Is someone busy? What are you doing? Oh yeah, one of them is actually building the building. Oh well, this is going to be the... Look, breadhead, we don't dig this stuff you fence us in with. We want an organic hedge that little animals can live in, right? Yeah. Yeah, so... There you go, the hippies get really pissed off if you don't give them a nice fence. Oh well. Also, I need to create...
What do you want?
Another one of these guys, or all these houses are going to get destroyed. As are these. How many have I got in here? Spare worker. Thank you. Yeah, these guys are probably reaching the end of their tenancy as well. Yeah, 104 days, they're all going to die off soon. But it does mean they'll be able to reproduce quicker, so I'll be able to get a move on. Dave and Fanny Rot. Oh, what a horrendous name you have. What's going on here? Everyone's complaining about my factory as usual.
Hello?
You go and sort out this complaint.
Righto. Who are I?
And...
Eh?
You go into the brick factory.
Righto.
I need another subway to speed things up. Everyone's wandering around very quickly. Very slowly, rather. This guy...
Are you kidding or what?
Go over here. Hello. Auto. Yeah, you see, very complicated. But the rent's coming in. That's good. I can start building brick houses in a minute, and then I can start getting things on track. Oh no, they're immediately unhappy for some reason. Probably because the factory's kicking in. But I don't know, punks usually like the factory making noise, so we'll see. I need to get these guys reproducing as soon as possible. How many tenants do I have in here? Level 1, 4. That's fine. These guys are all going to die for at the same time. Greasers live for a little bit longer, as you can see. I need to get producing level 2 tenants. Oh, these guys are starting to lose health.
Tea break.
Past half health, then you need to get them in the hospital because they're starting to become less efficient. There you go. The first slob has died. Bring them in. And I'll have some level 2 tenants. See how quickly they're going to reproduce for me now. Oh, the joys of new tenants. Oh, and when they die, the little angel goes off to heaven. Boom. You get me some more level 2 tenants as well. And then when these guys go, they can build workers. And... Ah, the school is built. Fantastic. Right, you guys need to get building level 3 tenants for me. Level 3 tenants for me. And I'll only have 2 reproduce. These guys reproduce really quick, so let's get these up to scratch. And I've got a subway here, so I don't need another one. Okay, my rent is going to go down though, so I want to get another level 2 tenant in here. If possible. Because these guys are going to produce level 2 tenants like crazy. 8 days left. Oh no. You're dead. Damn. Almost had another baby. You must be pretty old if you're by like 90 and having another baby. Okay. Let's say... What are you supposed to be doing? Let's have level 1s because we're almost out of level 1 tenants now. Who's complaining? It's my level 1s. Garden. I can deal with that. Yeah, I'm the best landlord or overlord in the world. Giving everyone trees and doing up their houses. Well, I guess if you're the landlord, you do have to do that, yeah. But buying them a computer, I mean, there is somewhere you need to draw the line at, right? Okay. You know what? I'm going to do this, and I think that's probably a good point to leave it at, actually. Slobs. Builders. Yeah, I need to check what's going on. So two in production, one in HQ, one in production. That's fine. That's how we like it. Okay, yeah. I have been Let Him Come In It. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Do let me know if there's anything you'd like to see in other current episodes coming up. And I will see you next time. Thank you and a good night.